When Michaela was 20 weeks pregnant with her third child, she not only learned that she'd be having a baby boy, she also learned that her baby boy had myelomeningocele, a severe form of spina bifida, a birth defect that occurs when bones in the baby's spine do not fully form during early pregnancy. This results in an opening in the baby's back.
I was not expecting to be told he had spina bifida. I was just like confused and lost at the moment.
Looking for answers, mom and dad made the journey to the Fetal Care Center at Cincinnati Children's.
So we complete the evaluation using different imaging techniques, and then we do a comprehensive meeting with a lot of specialists just to make the families to understand what's going on with their baby and try to offer the options.
After extensive testing, imaging, and counseling, Michaela was deemed a good candidate for fetal myelomeningocele surgery, a delicate operation to close the hole in her son's spine and utero. But they had to decide quickly.
We know that we have a window to offer the surgery in the mid-gestation. Usually the surgery is between 22 and 26 weeks. So it's a lot of process of information to these families just to recognize all the risks that moms and babies have having these surgeries, but also recognizing the benefits versus a postnatal surgery.
At that point, I was just like, I want to do what's best for him, what's going to give him the best life. Like, I was more concerned about him than I was myself at that point.
We can offer repair of the spina bifida postnatally in the first, second day of life. But at that point, the spinal cord, it's almost destroyed. So the goal of the prenatal surgery is just to stop that process. Most of the times we have good preservation of the legs and the foot movement. And also we are on time to revert the chiari and to stop the hydrocephalus.
I would say 31 weeks. And they had told me on an ultrasound that it was reversed. And I was just like, what? You're telling me what? And I was like, that's just like amazing. And to me, I was just like, something's already helped him and he's not even here yet.
It's not uncommon for babies who undergo fetal surgery to arrive early. At 34 weeks, 3 months after his fetoscopic surgery, Jaxyn was born during a scheduled C-section.
When we went to the NICU and I got to hold him for the first time and just see how he was okay and just knowing that his surgery was done with and he was in my arms and now it felt amazing.
All Jaxyn had to do now was keep up with his big brother and sister. Follow-up care at Cincinnati Children's and the Spina Bifida Clinic helped.
Patients who've had the prenatal surgery, they have a little bit increased chance of having more movement in their lower legs, and so therefore increasing potential for walking.
Come on, get sissy. Go, go, go.
When he started putting weight on his legs and walking, it was just along the couches and stuff like that. Once he started realizing how fast his feet could move, he just went for it.
Run, baby, run! Good job!
Jaxyn's been the one in the driver's seat as far as what he's doing and how things are going.
He walked into school. I never thought that was an image I would ever see. Trying to run, play on a playground, like I never thought any of this would be normal for him.
He's doing amazingly. When you see these babies like 2, 3, 4 years after, I think it's incredible, yeah.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.